Sunday 3 of our season of creation. And so far, we have learned about integrity, we have learned about hope, and how important it is to pass those things on to future generations. Just as it is important for us to pass on to future generations this great planet we call Earth, and all of the creation God has placed in it. Today, we talk about wisdom. Now, if any of you had, which I know you all have, read the e-news from this week and my lead article, I threw in some questions for you. The word wisdom is one of those words that we may struggle a little bit with. And the writer of Proverbs today introduces to us a person, or at least a personification, that we have come to know as Lady Wisdom. Now, when I was preparing for this Sunday, I was, of course, trying to decide, what am I going to put up on the screen during the sermon? Because something needs to entertain them when they get bored with my voice. And I ran across this one and I went, how perfect. Because it combines our two aspects of our season of creation. Do you notice all of the creation around and in and through Lady Wisdom? Lady Wisdom's also known as Sophia. And it is one of the few places in Scripture that a woman is used to personify a concept of God. And as we think about wisdom and what does it mean, it leads me to think about, well, who or what do I consider wise in my life? And so I thought, well, maybe it helps if I start trying to get some definition around this concept of wisdom. And so I went, as all good people now do, to Google, and I put in definition of wisdom, and it took me to all the different dictionaries. But actually, Wikipedia gave me exactly what I felt I needed to. So let me share this brief definition of wisdom, because it's from this definition that I want to launch the rest of what I share with you. Wisdom, or sapience, is the ability to think and act using knowledge, experience, understanding, common sense, and insight. That's the first of two sentences. Hear that? Knowledge, experience, understanding, common sense, and insight. Goes on with the second system. That's the word I wanted. Wisdom is associated with attributes such as compassion, experiential self-knowledge, non-attachment, and virtues such as ethics and benevolence. I went, wow, the writer of this read Scripture. This makes sense to me, because I think often we associate wisdom with knowledge. And you heard it was there, right? In fact, in our passage from Proverbs, we hear about knowledge, right? The speaker says, how long will you push away knowledge? Obviously, knowledge is part of wisdom. But it isn't the only thing that makes up wisdom. Because of individual can have a lot of knowledge. Many of you know that my background is Presbyterian. And one of the things that Presbyterians are well known for is a lot of head stuff, right? We tend to avoid this stuff because it gets messy. But we can handle this, right? A lot of head stuff. And that's important. It has value. But it's only important if we can understand that knowledge and apply that knowledge using things like common sense. Using things like awareness. The writer of Proverbs calls those to whom are receiving the message simple ones, because they're not applying this knowledge in a way of common sense and awareness. And so once I understood maybe what wisdom meant, it took me back to, okay, how do I see wisdom played out in life? Where do I see it played out in life? And then that took me to that second sentence. Attributes such as compassion. Compassion. Sometimes we can know a lot of good things. But if in that knowledge we don't handle it in a way of compassion, then that knowledge can actually be abrasive and problematic. And it is clear as I read in Scripture of the examples of Jesus that Jesus clearly had knowledge, right? Jesus could tell you exactly what the laws and the prophets said. But the thing that showed Jesus having wisdom was compassion. Jesus was compassionate to all those around. Virtues such as ethics and behavior and benevolence. Sometimes I wonder if those are virtues that have disappeared at times. Ethics, benevolence. People great power sometimes lose track of those attributes of wisdom. They lose track of, while I may be able to do something, I have the knowledge and the ability to do something, it may not be the right thing to do. And even though I may have the power and authority to have others do things that I wish for them to do, it may not be in the best interest of all. See, to me, that's what wisdom is. Wisdom is having the ability to look at life and to take all that God has given as a person, or us as a community, and be able to choose the right path, even if there are possibilities of choosing many. Jesus, in our gospel reading, is talking to his disciples then and is seeking to hear what knowledge they have, right? And says, who do people say that I am? Who do you say that I am? And then Jesus' wisdom prevails, right? Because after Peter says, you are the Messiah, Jesus says, don't tell anybody. And we think that's kind of strange, right? Why? Well, because, see, Jesus had wisdom. Jesus knew that right now was not the time to be telling other people that he's the Messiah. He goes on and he tells them about what's going to happen, right? Don't we all want that at times? Just tell us the future. Just, you know, let me know what's coming down the road. I'll be prepared. We'll be happy. And so he does. And Peter says, you are being a downer, okay? No, stop this right now. We're not going to talk about this. And Jesus says, wait a minute, Peter. I think the gospel writer is a little harsh. I don't know how hard Jesus hit Peter with the rebuke. But Jesus says, no, wait. See, here's another knowledge versus wisdom. Wait. You're focusing on the wrong thing. You're focusing on what will be right for here and now, what you want to feel, what you want to experience. And Jesus says you need to focus on what God says is right and what God says is the future. And then he gives those other harsh words to us, right? You want to follow me, you've got to deny yourself. Take up your cross and follow me. Again, wisdom comes in. Denying oneself, in the view of wisdom, is remembering that we make choices. And sometimes, we need to make choices that don't put our self-interest and needs first. That's wisdom. Is being able to know that. Being able to live that. And so, today, as we grapple with the concept of wisdom, and how do we pass this on? How do we give our future generations wisdom? I would tell you that I challenge you to do it through the way you live your life, the choices you make, the paths that you choose. Because I promise you, my friend, people are watching. People of our generation and people of future generations are watching and will be impacted by the example we set and the choices we make. Whether we're talking about taking care of this great creation, or how we live in community, we have a responsibility to help others realize what it means to be wise. What wisdom really is. And so I'd like to send you this morning with this question. How are you finding wisdom in others? God be all glory, honor, and praise.